In this video, we will see SAP PP shifts and intervals. Shifts and intervals we can put in an SAP PP work center. So in work center, how we will put a shifts and intervals? Next, the shifts and interval, if you take an example over here, day 1, day 2, and so on, day 5. So there is some sequence of shift 1, shift 2, and shift 3. So according to the capacity which is required, there will be a shift maintained, and that shift is maintain a start time of work, finish time of work, then under that what time you will take for a breaks. So that all will be maintained under the shifts and interval. So in practical, we will see how you maintain shifts and interval in work center.
In this practical, we are going to see work center shifts and interval. So in factory, there are shifts and interval as we have discussed in PPT. Right now, we will going to see how it will be maintained in SAP PP. Just in capacity header, in capacity view, there is capacity header. So in capacity header, you go toward this shift and interval. So here, there is by default one interval is present throughout the this work center. Whenever the work center will be present at whatever time, at that time this is the default. Okay, as per our setting, whatever the setting we have done, start time, end time, length, it is showing. Okay, length of break, okay, capacity utilization 100%. So number, this is operating time is 8 hours. Okay, capacity, then unit of measure. So we can create an interval over here like this. If you put interval, you can put a date, it is valid from some particular date. You can put as from this date to this date. Okay, so on these dates I want my work center should be working in different ways. So keep on enter. So if you enter, so here you will see Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. These are the weekdays. Okay, so here the start time, then end time of work center is there. If suppose I will put over here as okay 00, so my factory is starting on from start of the date. Okay, so end time of my factory is 2400 hours. Okay, so here you can able to see, okay, capacity utilization I will put as 90%, a length of break I will put as a 00. Minute. Okay. Next, the same way I will just copy and paste. But for Saturday and Sunday, there will be big days. So that will be off. So for that, I will put 00. So at the time of the capacity planning also, the person will be get that weekdays there will be no work, or if some hours will be there, then you can put for weekdays, you can work for some hours like this. Length of break I will make for all as 30 minutes. Okay. And the percent of utilization or this is 90%, 90%, 90%, 90%, 90%, 90%. Enter. So see over here the operating timing is coming. So for how many times there will be the operating time in there. Okay. Then the capacity. Okay. Capacity of 21 hours 50 minutes. Okay. So like this, if you make over here as 75%, see operating hour is changed 17.62. So this is the capacity utilization. Like this, for particular time period, like from 0106 to 017 to 3006 to 017, up to this days, this will be scheduling will be there. Okay, this is the shift times. Okay, and this is the interval where you will be get 30 minutes of length break. Okay, start time is this, end time is this, weekend there is no work. Over here we can see in this Saturday, Sunday there will be no work. 00 it already showed. If I put in weekend, I will start my work at 11. Okay, and will end at 3 o'clock. That is 15. I will put to enter. Then see here, 3.15 is nothing but the 3 hours 15 minutes is nothing but your working hours. Okay, then next in Sunday also you can do that one. Okay, so like this you can maintain a shift and intervals in work center, then afterwards save it. That has been saved. So like this you can maintain a shift and interval in work center.
In this video you have seen how you will maintain shifts and interval in work center. Thanks a lot.